We are going to sketch a graph of this equation right here. And this equation is going to have some asymptotes, going to have some intercepts. We're going to find them all and then sketch it off of that. So first thing I'm going to find is those asymptotes. Remember, asymptotes are these things that at extreme behavior, the function gets approximates but never actually reaches. So the first one I'm going to find is my vertical one. And I know that I can't divide by zero. So can't divide by zero. So when I would be dividing by zero is when this 2x plus 6 is actually equal to zero. So let me see, 2x plus 6 equals zero. Subtract 6 from both sides. Negative 6 divide by 2. X is negative 3. So I know I have an x-intercept at x equals negative 3. So let me sketch that in. So first off, I'm going to need my, oh, that was horrible, my x and y. First off, I'm going to need my x and y axes. Boop. And x cannot equal negative 3, so 1, 2, 3. So that x equals negative 3 right along this dotted line right here. Remember what that is? That's a gap in my graph. It's going to be something that this curve approximates as it tends towards, as y tends towards negative infinity and positive infinity. Okay, other asymptote. The other asymptote is as x approaches infinity, as x gets really big, what does y do? What does y approach? So I have this 6x minus 3 over 2x plus 6. And as x gets really, really large, what happens is this 6x and this 2x term start to dominate it. Like the minus 3 and the plus 6, they affect it a little bit, but not very much, especially when x is like a million or a billion. So notice I have 6 times something big divided by 2 times the same big thing. So basically, this will start to settle down to 6 divided by 2 to about 3. It will never get to 3 exactly, but it'll get closer and closer and closer to it as x gets larger and larger and larger. So that gives me a horizontal asymptote right here at y equals 3. And I'll label that. So now I have my asymptotes. I kind of know how it's framed. It looks like this is going to have a y-intercept and an x-intercept. So let me try and find those next. So my next piece will be, I'll try and find my y-intercept first. And my y-intercept is when x equals 0. When it hits that y-axis, x is 0 because it has no left or right motion. So let me plug in 0 for x. Y equals 6 times x, which is 0, minus 3 divided by 2 times x, which is 0, plus 6. So that's a 0, that's a 0. So I end up with negative 3 over 6, which is negative 1 half. So when x is 0, y is negative 1 half. So see, that is about here. So let me label that point 0, negative 1 half. So there's my y-intercept. Find my x-intercept. That's when y equals 0. My x-intercept is where it hits this x-axis. And notice that has no height, a height of 0. So y has to be 0. So I'm going to plug 0 in for y. So y, which is 0, equals 6x minus 3 divided by 2x plus 6. And I'm going to solve this for x. And so first thing is I noticed this in the denominator. It kind of makes it difficult to solve. So I'm going to multiply both sides by that denominator. Get it out of there. It's bugging me. 2x plus 6. So this times 0 is 0. Over here, this divides out to a 1. 2x plus 6 divided by itself is 1. So I'm left with 6x minus 3. Solve that. Add 3 to both sides. Divide by 6. Looks like x is 1 half. So when y is 0, x is 1 half. So there's my x-intercept at 1 half 0. Oops, that was a 0. So I know that this curve then is going to look something like this, wedged in between those asymptotes. And then just thinking over here, you know, I could plug a point in over here to get where it's at, but I know that it's going to basically be in there.